cryptocurrency is a speculative instrument at present. The news that we hear about cryptocurrency is all news about high prices that are being made or low prices that are being made, people becoming millionaires, people losing their wonderful, Bitcoin code. And so right now it's something that catches a lot of attention, but is not fundamental to the economy. I've often wondered whether or not there is some kind of fundamental value to cryptocurrency once you wipe away all of the speculative discussion and speculative activity. And I suspect there is. I suspect there is a demand for a way of transferring and storing value that is outside of the purview of the banking system, the global banking system. But just how to measure that and how to figure out what's the fundamental value is quite a challenge. There are a few basic things that coins, that a currency has to fulfill. It has to be a store of value, it has to be a unit of account, it has to be a method of transferring value. With Bitcoin, because it fluctuates so much, it's not a particularly good store of value, at least over the course of a week or a month or a year. You know, you could put in $100 worth today, and it could be worth $25 worth 2 weeks from now. So until it overcomes that particular feature, it's not a great currency. I don't know whether it's a good or a bad investment. I know it's very volatile, which means it goes up and down a lot. Over the long term, who knows whether there's going to be a permanent demand and value to it. There's certainly other risks beyond the fact that it goes up and down a lot. Some of them are pretty straightforward. There are occasional cases where a cryptocurrency exchange has been hacked and people just lose all their Bitcoin. Another fundamental risk is losing your key to your Bitcoin account. There's no place you can go look it up. Some of the money in ancient times actually resembles what we think of as cryptocurrency today. Cryptocurrency today mostly is currency that's created in a set of accounts, a ledger. So there's no physical Bitcoin, for example, but you have your own account that you can buy and sell and trade the Bitcoin with other people. And so that transaction can be thought about it just as it's really an accounting transaction more than anything else. So even before coins were invented, the way the value was transferred in ancient cities was through a system of accounts. And so if you and I lived in the same city and you're a baker and I make pottery, we want to exchange value, we might say, look, my pot is worth 3 shekels of silver and you're baking bread that's worth 1. So let's agree to a transaction and you credit me for 1 and I credit you for the other. We may call it shekels of silver, but we're not using actual pieces of silver. So that's kind of the way Bitcoin is working now. There's no physical transfer. In some sense, we're going back to the time before we had anonymous money, transferable money by physical processes. So that kind of makes it exciting. It brings the ancient history of money up to the present. And you can see both kinds of methods solve different kinds of problems.